Now, if you were to take a look a little more carefully at these photoreceptors and actually look at them for real, you would see two types. You would see rods and cones. Now, we've looked at this picture before when we were talking about color, but now we want to talk about the anatomy. So the rods are these little skinny structures here, and there are something like, it says 120 million rods plus or minus within your retina. They are very, very light sensitive, about 1,000 times more light sensitive than the cones, if given time to adapt. We'll see that in a minute. And it can sort of help you discriminate between different illumination levels at very low overall illumination. The other structures here are the cones, and we've actually seen these before. The cones are the things that allow you to discriminate color, and we talked about them when we talked about the short, medium, and long wavelength cones. The cones are also the ones that are packed within your, what are called your fovea, that is that middle area that has the very high resolution. We'll talk about the impact of that in a minute. And it's the cones that give you sort of what we tend to think of as the high quality vision, and the rods sort of provide everything else. Now, by the way, even if you didn't have an electron microscope, and even if you hadn't sort of peeled apart people's retinas, which sounds kind of gross, you would know that there are at least two kinds of systems going on in the eye. One of the ways that this was discovered is in what's referred to as dark adaptation experiments, okay? So in dark adaptation, here's what we do. We put you in a dark room for months at a time. No. You put somebody in a dark room, and you, let's say after 1 minute, you say, how bright a light do I have to have a light to be before you can tell that it's on? Okay? So you do that. And then later we do it all over again, and we do it for 2 minutes. And then we do it for 3 minutes. Right? So we track to see how much light you need in order to detect that there's some illumination. Now, we've all had this experience before, right? You walk in from a bright daylight into a dark room, and it takes a little while, we say, for your eyes to adjust. Well, that adjustment is not your pupil opening and closing. That's a rapid response. What's happening is that the photoreceptors in your eye are adjusting to the amount of light. All right? And if I were to track that, I would see this kind of a curve. Okay? I would see a curve that starts going down like this and starts to look like it's going to flatten out. And then somewhere, this says about 8 minutes, varies on person to person, somewhere around there, all of a sudden, it starts to drop down again, okay? What's happened is your rods are now kicking in. Your rods are now coming into play. And you can go way much, much, much lower threshold, all right? And so, you know, when you have a single system, you never get psychophysical curves that have sharp breaks like that, right? And basically, what you're seeing here is there are two curves. There's a curve here for cones and a curve here for rods. And this was where they intersect, all right? And this is sort of a well-known phenomena, which implied that there was multiple systems within the retina in terms of light sensitivity.